We're going to talk about the idea of partial fractions. We've just seen that it's often easier to integrate a rational expression if we're able to break it down into summands, other smaller fractions added together, than it is to integrate the original function. Let's look at the specific example to see how this would work. We have x minus 8 over x squared minus x minus 2, and we'd like to integrate. So the first thing we want to do is see if we can figure out what fractions we could have added together to get this expression. To do that, we're going to start by factoring the denominator. So x squared minus x minus 2 is equal to x plus 1 times x minus 2. So we can rewrite our integral as x minus 8 over x plus 1 x minus 2. Now, the thing to notice here is that if this fraction was the answer to an addition problem between two fractions, the only possible fractions you could have to add together to get this fraction are something over x plus 1 plus something over x minus 2. So why is that the case? If we add these two, we get a common denominator. It's x plus 1 times x minus 2. If we add another fraction here with something else on the bottom, then our common denominator would be x plus 1 times x minus 2 times whatever this other thing is. And since there's no other factor here in the bottom, the only possibility is that this is actually one of the things we already had, like x plus 1, in which case you could just combine these two. Or maybe it's just 1, but if the bottom was 1, then when you went to find a common denominator, the degree of the top would have to be at least x squared. Because notice that our bottoms here, this one would be an x, and this would be an x. Multiplying those together, when we got the common denominator, would give us an x squared on top. And an x squared on top would mean that our final answer would have to have an x squared on top, and it doesn't. The highest power on the final answer is just x. So there's no other possible fractions that we could have added. It has to be something over x plus 1 plus something over x minus 2. Now the other thing to notice is for the same reason, the something over x plus 1 has to just be a number, and the something over x minus 2 has to just be a plain number. If it was anything fancier, if, say, there was an x here, then when we did a common denominator and we multiplied by x plus 1 over x plus 1, we would suddenly have an x squared term, which we don't have in the numerator of our final answer. So hopefully I've convinced you that if you have a fraction where in the bottom you just have two linear factors, meaning x plus or minus a number, the only possible partial fraction decomposition, the only possible two things you could add together to get that would be a number over x plus 1 plus another number over x minus 2. So we call this the partial fraction decomposition. So now what can we do with that? Well, we want to find a and b. Well, we know that this is supposed to be equal to this expression that we actually want to break down. So that would tell us that x minus 8 over x plus 1 x minus 2 should equal a over x plus 1 plus b over x minus 2. Well, how do we find a and b? Well, if we add these two together, we know how to add fractions, we should get something in the same form as our original rational expression. So we have x minus 8 over x plus 1 x minus 2 equaling, if I want to get a common denominator, then I want to multiply a over x plus 1 times x minus 2 over x minus 2. So this is going to be a over x minus 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 2 plus, now I want to multiply the second fraction by x plus 1 over x plus 1. So I get b times x plus 1 over x minus 2 times x plus 1. I can simplify this by adding these two fractions together now. So I have x minus 8 over x plus 1, x minus 2, equal to a, x minus 2, plus b, x plus 1, over x plus 1, x minus 2. So now we have two fractions equaling each other. The denominators are already the same. So the only way these two fractions can be equal is if the numerators are equal. So we now have that x minus 8 must equal a times x minus 2 plus b times x plus 1. So now, can we figure out a and b? Well, we can, because let's FOIL out the right side and simplify it. We have ax minus 2a plus bx plus b. And so we have a plus b times x. That's the coefficient on x if we combine these two like terms. Plus negative 2a plus b. That's the coefficient on 1. So if I combined these two like terms. And now we're going to do something that's called the equal coefficients method. The argument here is if you have two polynomials equal to one another, here we have x minus 8 equal to a plus bx plus negative 2a plus b. That's our constant term. We don't really need that times 1. The only way those two polynomials can be equal is if their coefficients are equal. So that means that whatever number is in front of x on this side has to be in front of x on this side. So that gives us that 1 is equal to a plus b, because the coefficient of just plain x is 1. And similarly, whatever number is the constant on this side has to be the constant on this side. So that gives us that negative 8 is equal to negative 2a plus b. Now we have a system of two equations and two unknowns, so we can solve this. The simplest way is probably to solve one equation for one variable. So solve this equation for b. B is equal to 1 minus a. And then we're going to substitute that in to the other expression. So we're going to get negative 8 is equal to negative 2a plus 1 minus a. Simplifying gives us that negative 8 is equal to negative 3a plus 1. So negative 9 is equal to negative 3a, or a is equal to 3. Now that we know a, we can find b by plugging back into this expression. So we get that b is equal to 1 minus 3, so b is equal to negative 2. We've now determined our numbers a and b. So what that means is that our original expression, which was x minus 8 over x squared minus x minus 2, is equal to, let's see, a was over x plus 1. So 3 over x plus 1, and then b, so negative 2, over x minus 2. So now we have done the partial fraction decomposition. We've rewritten our rational expression as a sum of two fractions. So what does this mean? This means that our original integral can now be computed by integrating these expressions instead. All right, so how do we do that? Well, we can do each problem separately since there's an addition sign in between them. And these are each just natural log straightforward integrals. Technically, we would do u equals x plus 1 for this equation, du is equal to dx, and we would transform the integral. Hopefully you can see pretty quickly that that just gives you 3 natural log of the absolute value of x plus 1. Plus, on this one, we get negative 2 natural log of the absolute value of x minus 2 plus c. On this equation, we would use the substitution u equals x minus 2, and du is equal to dx. So now we've done a simple example of partial fraction decomposition. Let's review. First, we started with a rational expression that we didn't know how to integrate as is. So you always want to check first that you can't just do something like a u substitution, u equaling the bottom, make sure you don't get the top, or anything else very simple. The next thing we did was factor the bottom. Then we convinced ourselves of the form of the partial fraction decomposition. If the factoring it just looks like a bunch of linear factors, it's going to be a number over each linear factor. Then we did some algebra here to actually determine that a and b. We equated our original expression with our new expression, and we solved for it. Notice that what we ended up doing, we did a lot of algebra steps that we're familiar with, but eventually where we ended up was this step right here. And once we got to the part where we equated numerators, we were able to do the equal coefficients method. This allowed us to actually determine a and b. After we determined a and b, we could now do a new integral that was easier to solve.